a job well done as far as you're concerned?
Yes, absolutely, because those games are not easy. It's another competition. It's a cup, and for us going to a cup the way we did, and against a team that they really put it difficult for us for the majority of the game, was important for us to do it the way we did it, and it was not easy, not like very comfortable, and when we got the first goal, it's too early, and then it was not easy to get the second in, and some spells of the game they put it very difficult for us. Yeah.
What about the sort of newcomers into the team? First up for Ede, how did you think he did?
We're very happy with his work, like with the whole team. Our club has been growing much, and now we have a very competitive squad, and a little bit all of them they had time to play and to show what they can do. Eder is one of them, and the whole team was offered a big effort. Eder was very incisive, was very mobile. He had chances. He was very aggressive. He was always ready to press when we lost the ball, and he was using his movement and his abilities very wisely in coordination with all the other ones, so we pleased with this game.
And Jonjo Shelby gave a little cameo display at the end, some lovely passing, particularly for the third goal. I mean, there's much talk of Jonjo being back in the England squad, which is named on the weekend. You probably feel he hasn't played better, has he? If he's ever going to get recalled, now is the time?
Well, Jonjo's working very hard for himself, for the club, to help his teammates, and he has the ability that he sees passing and sees movement in front of him, and when he's playing as a midfielder, he can always deliver good passing, good ball, especially that end up with shot on goal, like the last goal from Marvin. And Jonjo is in a good moment, in a good shape, and with a lot of confidence, and we wish him that he could get it, but this is up to the England manager to decide. I assume that the competition has to be very, very high in that.
But you and the club would feel he's ready for it if he is called in now?
Yeah, absolutely.
Matt Grimes, it's obviously a big step up coming, as he did, from League Two to a Premier League club. Tonight was obviously an important milestone for him, would you agree?
Yeah, I agree. I agree that as well as all the other ones. But Matt is a young player coming through the lower leagues, and today he showed things a little bit more confidence, and a big step forward as growing into a player, and he's been helping us the whole game for it, and I think he deserves the credit that you can give him.
And it would be important for him that he's got his first goal in the first team.
Yeah, in official competition, yeah, right.
What does it say about the strength of the squad, Pep, that you can change the whole team and still win 3-0 and could easily have been more than 3-0 with the chances you created?
Yeah, that's very good. That's very good that, as we said before, that the club got to that point that we have positions doubled, and it gives a lot of competition for us in the trainings, in the work. The whole squad is working very hard to get the minutes and put it very difficult to each other. And afterwards, there's a good atmosphere in the group. And for this reason, we're satisfied to get to that point that everyone can compete, and we're a little bit wider, because you know this game, and difficult situations will come. There's going to be suspensions or injuries that we hope we don't get. But that is important that the club got to that point that we have much competition there and everyone is ready to. But I would not agree like that the game should not be that, that it's like, understand that. It could have seemed easier today, but remember that we've been 1-0 for a big part of the game, and it could have been, they had the chance to score the 1-1 in the second half, so it could have been different, but the confidence on the squad is huge from
Which
us.
Which of the players today do you think will be in competition for Saturday?
Yeah, well, they all put it hard for the manager to decide, and they all work very, very hard to get in, and anyone could really play here or could really play in the league, any of our players.
And with the strength of the squad, is this competition, I mean, you won it 2.5 years ago, but with the greater strength now of the squad, is this a competition Swansea City can realistically target along with the priority of the Premier League status?
Yeah, that's a good point in what you're saying. I don't know if it's a competition that we can target, but it absolutely gets us to the point that we can do this old saying that go game by game and try to win every game, focused on every game, you know. So now we can focus on today, and tomorrow we can focus on the next game, always with the will to fight and compete it. And not sometimes we struggle a little bit more with more competitions. Right now, this squad is strong enough and wide enough to be able to compete for these two competitions, like a league and a cup. And I don't know if we should say that we should target one of them. You know, I think we have to go game by game and focus 100% on trying to get the best out of every game at every time.
There was talk that Norwich might be interested in Jordi Amat. Any news you can add on to that at all?
No, I don't have. This is a question that you can ask to the manager on the next time you speak to him, because
the transfer window coming very close to the end. Any openings there, do you think?
Yeah, it's closing next week, imagine. But it's a question as well that outside from this game, I will not be able to help you on that.